Secondary design requirements. When a flexural member is designed, it is mainly made competent to take maximum factored bending moment as per requirements of limit state of collapse under flexure. Side-by-side provisions are made for other critical limit states. 1. To impose shear strength more than maximum factored shear force as per requirements of limit state of collapse under shear. 2. Proper development length at supports. 3. Maximum deflection within permissible values of serviceability requirements, described as limit state of serviceability under deflection. For all of above calculations, we need different formulae as per requirements of limit states design. Few parameters are also used in every calculation, so it is now necessary to explore all those formulae and parameters first. Clear cover CC and effective cover CA. The cover provided to shield reinforcement against corrosion is known as clear cover. The following clear covers are usually taken as per the type of structural member. Clear cover CC. It is the distance between outer fiber of the reinforcement bar to the nearest edge of the concrete section. Top cover. If measured at top, it is the distance between top edge of concrete section to outermost fiber of reinforcement bar. Then it is called top cover. Bottom cover. If measured at bottom, it is the distance between bottom edge of concrete section to outermost fiber of reinforcement bar. Then it is called bottom cover. Side cover. If measured at side, it is the distance between side edge of concrete section to outermost fiber of reinforcement bar. Then it is called side cover. Recommendations for clear cover are: for beams, cantilevers, or any other elementary flexural member, clear cover is taken as below minimum value, CC equals 25 millimeters. For slabs, either one-way or two-way slabs, clear cover is taken as below minimum value, CC equals 15 millimeters. For circular or rectangular column sections, clear cover is taken as below minimum value, CC equals 40 millimeters. For isolated and combined footings, clear cover is taken as below minimum value, CC equals 60 millimeters. Now understand effective cover, CA. It is the distance between center of tension reinforcement and bottommost fiber of the concrete section. Effective cover can be obtained by adding half the diameter of the tension reinforcement to the clear cover. CA equals CC plus 1/2 times phi. Here, phi equals diameter of the tension reinforcement. Horizontal and vertical spacing between reinforcing bars, represented by SH and SV respectively. First we take minimum vertical spacing, that is SV. When bars are in vertical lines, minimum vertical distance between the bars shall be greater of the following, as per IS 456 code recommendations. A. 15 mm. B. 2/3 of nominal maximum size of the concrete. C. Maximum diameter of the bar. Now let us understand minimum horizontal spacing, that is SH, should not be less than of the below two values. A. Diameter of largest bar. B. Nominal size of aggregate plus 5 mm. Side face reinforcement in beams. For beams having larger depths and are prone to torsion or twist, should be provided with bars at sides of the sections. If required, section becomes deeper than overall depth of 750 mm, then extra care is needed in terms of side face reinforcement in beam sections. Provide side reinforcement equal to or more than 0.1% of the total area of reinforcement provided for web, and distribute equally on sides. The spacing between bars should not exceed 300 mm of web thickness of section, whichever is less.
For complete course and step-by-step illustration, please subscribe full course on Structural Analysis and Design app. Also subscribe YouTube channel Matrix Digital Solutions. Thanks for watching.